Hello everyone, I'm Suzanne Migdell, councillor from the City of Stirling. The City of Stirling established the biannual History and Heritage Awards to recognise the efforts made by individuals and groups in the pursuit of conserving the city's history and heritage. These awards are held every second year to recognise individuals and community groups that have contributed to the promotion of heritage throughout the built environment within the Stirling community. The city has a diverse urban landscape that reflects a myriad of building and design styles that go all the way back to the time of settlement. It's therefore important to conserve our heritage, and these awards play an important part in encouraging this.
Hi, my name is Mark Beattie and I'm a heritage consultant with Element Advisory. It's a privilege to be here representing Element as the heritage advisor to this year's judging panel. The conservation of our heritage buildings provides us with a sense of place as a community. It's evident around the world that where heritage is understood and valued by the community, it's invariably better cared for and creates aesthetically pleasing streetscapes that display layers of history interwoven with contemporary living, as can be seen here around us in the Mount Lawley Protection Area. Custodianship of our heritage buildings from one generation to the next stands as a testament to our civic pride and connects us to where we call home. In a world where we're being encouraged to socially distance, it has never been more important for us to recognise how heritage can contribute to our shared identity and offer continuity in a changing world. That continuity would not be possible without the care and attention of you, the owners. On behalf of Element and as heritage advisors to the city, I'm privileged to have taken part in this year's judging. It's Element's fifth time being part of the judging panel, and every year we finish the day of visits astounded by the level of research and care given to each property. We usually also finish the judging with a major sense of home envy due to the quality of workmanship and materials on display. This year was possibly the most diverse collection of properties we have ever visited, ranging from Federation era villas in Mount Lawley to 1970s modernist icons in Carnyup. New infill development, extensions, community-run facilities and small businesses, all demonstrating a sound understanding of good heritage management principles. The key principle being that all heritage renovations should be based on an understanding of what's significant about the property before changing it. This allows the most important bits to be retained and ideally enhanced in the renovation. It goes without saying that each of the commended and winning entries have gone above and beyond demonstrating this. Congratulations to all the winners and commendations, but thank you to all applicants for your continued care for our shared heritage.
Mark and I are pleased to announce the winners of the Heritage category for 2020. Category 1, Conservation of the Built Environment and Streetscape. This award is aimed at promoting the conservation of heritage places in the built environment. For example, a building or group of buildings, a private garden, a public park, ruins, or a streetscape.
3 Wenbury Lane, Mount Lawley, received a commendation for design and infill development. This is a highly considerate and well-designed piece of urban infill, which respects the adjacent streetscape character and helps to activate a lane in the city's heritage protection area. Congratulations to the owners of 17 Inverness Crescent Menorah for a high commendation. The owners have taken great care in researching and understanding the history of this property, and as a result, have been able to retain and conserve the original intent of the building's interwar character. The outcome is an elegant 21st century home with an Art Deco splendour at its heart. This property also gets a commendation for their garden and its design. Its transformation has improved the visual transparency to the heritage building from the street and improved the overall setting of such an iconic house in the city's heritage protection area.
This year we have joint winners for this category. Forming part of a sensitively designed home renovation at 49 Clotilde Street, Mount Lawley, the reconstruction of the veranda and external conservation of this property has been delivered with expert quality, craftsmanship and attention to detail. The skills and techniques used are of a standard rarely seen on typical home renovation projects of this scale. As a result, the overall outcome enhanced the presence of this iconic property in the streetscape. It is considered a benchmark standard for home renovations in the city's heritage protection area and is worthy of recognition as a joint winner. Featherley House, 41 Summerhays Drive, is an extraordinary renovation of a rare and highly significant Ivan Ivanov designed residence. The research to gain an understanding of the building's original design and specification has resulted in an authentic and highly skilled recreation of Ivanov's original intent. It is considered that the restoration has enhanced the heritage significance of the property by improving the interpretation of this architectural style. Particular mention should go to the quality of the workmanship undertaken to restore the cabinetry internally, which is an accurate reproduction of the original. Featherby himself was a cabinet maker, and this was the focus of the original home.
Category 2. Education and the promotion of heritage. Winner, Osborne Park Uniting Church, 164 Edward Street. For over 100 years, the congregation of this church have taken great care in maintaining the building as an asset to the community. In doing so, they have educated the broader community on the value of heritage and conservation while promoting the use of this building into the future. A remarkable story of community-led restoration. When this community built the church in 1915, they probably did not expect this modest building would one day have heritage value. It is through their combined efforts that this building remains and has significance to the city today and into the future.
Many within the city of Stirling would be familiar with Mr. Barry Baker, patron of the Mount Lawley Society. In 2014, a Heritage Award category was named after Barry in recognition of his involvement in the promotion of heritage values over the past 40 years and his extraordinary dedication to the cause. I am pleased to invite Barry to announce the winner of the Barry Baker Special Recognition Award.
I'm very pleased to announce that the Barry Baker Special Recognition Award has been awarded to Margaret Summers for the loving care she and her Kellow family over the generations have given to Windsor Hall, 36 Queen's Crescent, Mount Lawley. This highly significant heritage landmark has been in the ownership of the same Kellow family since 1938. The building demonstrates successive waves of occupation over the last 117 years and stands a tribute to the development of this area. And it's now a significant piece of our community's social history and heritage. Over three generations of this family has conserved the building's contribution to the Mount Lawley streetscape and have taken an active role in the promotion and conservation of the Mount Lawley Heritage Protection Area.
On behalf of the City of Stirling, I would like to thank all entrants this year for contributing to conserve our heritage, and these awards play an important part in enriching the cultural legacies within the city. Thank you.